Hi guys, I am Meeka and welcome to my channel. It's December and it's officially the wedding season in India. Every second person is getting married. Well, except for you and me, of course. Well, I've created this makeup look for when you want to look your absolute best at the wedding and outshine the bride very subtly. So if you don't want to look like you're trying too hard and still want to kill it with your looks at this wedding season, then please keep on watching.
So first, I'm going to use a moisturizer to moisturize my face, and I'll be using the Nivea Soft Moisturizer. Next up, I'm going to use an orange color corrector to conceal the dark circles under my eyes and the pigmentation on my face. So I'm just going to swirl my finger in it and lightly apply dots of the color corrector or any pigmentation which I have on my face. So the one thing to remember about color correctors is that a little goes a long way, and the best way to blend in the color corrector is using your fingers because they are pretty warm. Next, I'm going to take in this 24 hour super stick foundation by Maybelline. This is a full coverage foundation which you will be needing to cover all the flaws and the pigmentation on your face because you want to look your best at the wedding. This one trick I've learned all the years I've been doing makeup is that never go in with too much of foundation all at once. Just take one or one and a half pump at the start, and if you require more, then go in with the second layer of foundation. And that's what I'm going to do now because I need one more layer of that extra coverage today. So one more pump. For the concealer, I'm going to use this Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Concealer. I'm in the shade C12. So this is how I apply concealers always. And so many people say that you should make an inverted triangle under your eyes so that it covers up and highlights your under eye area more. But that doesn't work really well for me. I have tried and tested it a lot of times. This is what works the best for me, putting in 3 strokes like this under my eyes. And you can try this trick too because I think this will work really well in general for everyone. To set my base makeup, I'm going to use this banana powder shade from Wet n Wild. This is the contour and banana shade palette, and this is the shade Caramel Toffee. I'm going to use this brightening banana powder over here. So now for the eyeshadow, I'm going to use this Huda Beauty Desert Dust Palette. It is such a beautiful palette. I got it for 50% off on the Nykaa Pink Friday sale. And the shades are so freaking beautiful. So I am going to try and experiment because I just want to do something really different and offbeat to stand out from the crowd at the wedding. So let's see. I think first I'll go with this shade right over here, Desert Sand, to just brighten my eyelid. So I just took it on a flat brush and I'm just going to cover the eyelid with it. So for the crease, I want to start with this shade Amber right over here. It's this brown shade. And what I was thinking is that I start with a brown shade from the outer corner of my crease and then change the shade later on. Well, let's see how it turns out to be. Now for the second crease shade, I thought I will go with this shade over here, Blazing. It's this orange shade. Let's see how it looks. Now I'm taking this blending brush and I'm going to blend both the shades together so that they look seamless. Now my crease shadows are blended, so now I'm going to take the same blending brush. I'm going to take the orange shade right again and I'm going to form sort of a V, like a light V right here, so that the color looks even. Like what I'm trying to opt for is that the crease starts from here, the brown and the orange, and it ends right over here, and a new shade starts from the center of the V. Now for the main lid color, I thought I'll go with this super pretty shade Retrograde. It is super, it just looks very, very different. I have not owned a shade like this and I wanted to try this one. So yay, I'm excited for this one. This shade looks amazing and now I'm going to blend both of these shades in. I really like this combination, but I thought to amp it up a little, I'll go with the shade Twilight over here. Let's see how it looks. Now for a cleaner line of the eyeshadow, I'm going to take my concealer and just draw a line over here. Now I'm going to take the same shades for the waterline, like below my lower eyelashes. And I'm just going to put it in the waterline below my eyelashes. Now I'm going to take this smudger brush, pointed one. And I'm going to take the shade Nefriti, okay, this one, it's a goldenish shade, and I'm just going to put it in the inner corner of my eyes to make my eyes pop. Add in some kajal in my waterline, this one's by K Beauty by Katrina. Now I'm going to clean my under eye shadow with my concealer. I've taken a little concealer on this brush and I'm just going to clean. Now I'm going to take the same shade which I took for the inner corners of my eyes and I'm going to use it as my brow highlighter above my brows, like below my brows. So I love doing this trick on my eyebrows, like on my brow bone, because it highlights my brow bones a lot and it gives a lot of definition to my eyes. Now for my brows, I'm going to use this Etude Drawing Eyebrow Pencil. It's in the shade Grey Brown and I'm just going to brush my brows. So for the contour, I'm going to take this same contour palette by Wet n Wild and I'm going to take this big fan brush and I'm just going to swirl it and make this fish face. And so you start your contour from the start of your ears and you go down till the midpoint of your cheek, like this. Now for the blush, I'm using this Miss Claire Mineral Blush Palette. I dropped the brush. Okay, so I'm going to use these two shades of blush. I'm just going to mix them up because this gives a really healthy shine to your face. Like it looks pretty healthy and your skin glows and it looks really, really nice. So. For the highlighter, I'm taking this Wet n Wild stick highlighter, and I'm just going to swirl my fingers on this and apply it with my fingers. I've realized it applies better with my fingers than the stick itself, and I'm going to put this on the high points of my face. Now for the lipstick, I am going for a nude shade because there's a lot going on the eyes and I just want to keep the lips simple but pretty elegant. So I'm using this Maybelline Superstay lipstick in the shade Amazonian. I love this lipstick. It's a very pretty nude. It looks really nice.
So guys, this is the final makeup look. I absolutely love how it's looking and I can't wait to try it out at the wedding season. I mean, it's almost here and I opted for a white lehenga because I love white and you can never really go wrong with white. Also, don't forget to accessorize it up and look your very best at the wedding season and channel your inner goddess. And I'll see you all girls super soon. I love you all and have a great day. Bye.